Welcome to this new Dynamo playlist. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create Dynamo scripts that will help you automatically model columns in Revit. So you can simply use them in different projects and save a lot of time. So let's get started. We will first go to the library and type number slider. Pick the number slider node and select it and press Control. Create three copies of it. Now we will double click and create a code block. Write (2.hash x, 2.hash y). We will link the first number slider with the x and the second with the y. Now we will go back to the library and write by coordinates, point by coordinates. Make sure, we need the x, y, z node. Just the second one. Okay. Now we will link the output of the code block with the x. We will duplicate it and link the third number slider with the y of the second node. Now we will simply slide them so we can view the line or the points of our columns. Go back to the library and write by start point, end point. Line by start point, end point. And we will link the first point and point by coordinates by the start point and the second node output with the end point. So this is going to be the number. For example, we can simply keep it at 3. The second number slider will be for the distance between each two lines, and the third number slider will be the length of each line. We're currently creating our grids system so we can then create the columns. So you can slide them, or you could simply select it and write and type the number you want. Now we'll go back to the library and search for grids node, byline grid, and link the line with lines, and we have created our grids for the x coordinates. Now we will select them, create a group, give it a name, and then select the whole group, and we'll need to duplicate it so we can create the other direction of the grids. We'll change the name and we'll do a little bit of modifications so we can change the direction. We will go to point by coordinates and link the x and link the y. Do the same below. And go to the third number slider, which is for length, and simply link it with the x now. Just gonna do a little bit of adjustment so we can make sure that we have all the lines crossed. And yes. So now we have created our grids. Now we'll go back to the library and write geometry. Translate. Now we need geometry intersect first. Okay, pick the node. Now we'll go to line by start point end point and link the line with geometry, then link the one below with other. Now as you can see, the intersection only happened in the middle of the model. So we need to adjust that to make sure that whenever two lines are intersecting, they are creating a point. So we will right click, go to lacing, and make sure that it's cross product. That way you have created points whenever two lines are intersecting. And therefore, there are the points for our columns. Now we'll go back to Library and go to Geometry Translate. Make sure to choose the X translation, Y, and Z translation. Obviously, link geometry with geometry, and then we will need an elevation, which is the Z translation. Double click to create a code block and give whichever value you need. I'm going for 3. I'm working with a metric system. Make sure to choose your units in Revit before starting work with Dynamo. Now we will go back to the library and choose the by start point end point, creating lines by start point end point. So we can link the lines we have created after the points we have created after the elevation. So geometry translate will be linked with the input end point and line by start point, and geometry intersect will be the start point. That way we have created the lines for our columns. Now we need to create the 3D geometry. We will go to column by curve and choose it. We will obviously link the line with a curve. We need another node for levels and another one for structural column type. So if you already have this package installed, you need to do that in order to perform the rest of the tutorial. So go to packages in the home menu and wait a little. It takes a while depending on your internet speed. Then type structural design. Scroll down until you find structural design. Mine is installed, but you should install your package. It's obviously for free. Now we need the node for levels. We will go to library and type levels. Select it. And choose whichever levels we need our columns to be in. Next, we need the node for structural column type. We will write structural column type. Okay, select it. And simply link it with the input in structural framing. Now if we go back to Revit to check the result, we can simply view that our columns have been modeled. Now you can simply select them, change them individually, or change all of them. If you don't want them to move with the grids, if you want them to, you can edit the type, you can do whichever modifications you want to do to your model. And obviously, as I always say, you should save your Dynamo script and use it in future projects to save time, because this is the reason why we're doing all of this. And that's it. If you like the video, like and subscribe if you're interested in content like that, whether specifically in Dynamo or in other construction softwares or BIM softwares. You can check the rest of my videos, and thank you for watching.